As you,
yes,
as you can tell, it's a whole process for us to really make it to these sessions every Wednesday.
So yay, we're recording.
And again, we're recording. Welcome. We will later on be on YouTube. Welcome everyone. So everyone who's new and eager to learn, welcome again. And I'll just go quick a little bit so we can go to introduce Sara. Remember to be nice and kind and pathetic. And Mim, please introduce us to
so
Sara.
We have Sara in the house, everybody. Can we clap? Woo!
Yay!
Yes. Yay. We've met Sara. Me and Humaina met Sara so many times in different sessions, whether it be like Big Reset or like Lee Kim's session or like Sara's own sessions. So like, we're so happy to finally have her at the jam again. So yay! Welcome, Sara.
Welcome.
And welcome. And now, Sara, the floor is yours.
The floor is yours.
Please, Danny.
Thank you, Mim, and thank you, Humaina. And welcome, everyone. Whether you're a regular, like in a pub, and you know everyone, or you're here for the first time, I see you and I'm happy that you're here on this Wednesday. I'm calling from the Netherlands. You can't see it. It's King's Day today. And King's Day is basically, I would say, an excuse of getting drunk and sell random crap on the street. I have no idea why. I've been here for 30 years, more than 30 years, and it still really surprised me each year why people sell random crap on the street. So I'm happy that you're here to share this session with me about feelings. But before doing that, I would like to invite you just to tune in within yourself and check. Introducing, like, where are you even calling from? What is the last food eaten by you? And how is your internal weather right now? So for me, I'm calling from Rotterdam. I just ate tompoes, which is very Dutch. It's like milfoei met with the custard. And my internal weather is cloudy with a dash of sun. So take a moment for yourself, and whenever you're ready, share that in the chat. Thank you. And just when you are have shared your answer, just take a look in the chat and seeing all these different input coming in, whether it's about the places that people are calling from, the last food eaten like a strawberry smoothie, or how their internal weather is. Ooh, a little bread, pauzinho in Portuguese with jam. Calling from Germany. Ooh, a piece of favorite chocolate. And maybe you can even notice in how I read those answers, but in the things that we read or even can relate to, there's a reaction happening inside of you. And maybe there's recognition or there's something about the curiosity. So thank you for all these answers and keep them coming in. And if you just arrived, take some time to settle first. So today is, as I said before, unfortunately Lily cannot join me, but Lily has designed all these lovely artwork. So I'm not taking any credit, but all these lovely work is done by Lily. And we've done this session before for the Creative Mornings as a field trip. But today is about the Museum of Unnamed Feelings. And, let me check. Yes, here you go. And what I would like to invite you to do next is to, I think everybody knows how to annotate, but if not, because there's everything for the first time, you should see like you're viewing Sara's screen, and then next to that, that will be something you can have a drop down, and then you can use the annotate tool. And my invitation then to you is to stamp three feelings that are the components of your internal weather. And if annotate does not work for you, you can also just share them in the chat. But please use the annotate to share what are the feelings that made up for your internal weather. Ooh, I'm seeing enthusiastic, optimistic, isolated, depressed, passion, delighted, happy, cheerful, confused, excited, caring, depressed, hurt, agony. And just enjoy this process as well as people come in and leave their mark on this feeling wheel. And notice the layers while this interactive artwork, so to speak, appear before our eyes. Thank you. And also notice within yourself, when I'm asking for feelings, not one, not two, but three, that you have the choice to go through the wheel and not just to say happy or caring, but can also choose for something that's maybe sad or shameful or stunned. What does it do for you when you have those choices of the different feelings? You don't have to share the answers, but just notice within yourself. So for the next bit about those feelings is an embodied experience. And why I ask you to stamp those feelings is because that, so I listened to this morning, and according to neuroscientists shared by Shaquille Chaudhry in Canada,
Bless you, Sarah. Bless you. Drink water.
Thank you. So feeling don't worry. From this emotional state, I always believe in the present moment as well. I think the universe is even telling me, talking about feelings, it can be itchy. Maybe there's itchiness in the room as well. So express it instead of holding it in, but try to find a way to express it. So I was listening to a talk by Shaquille Chaudhry by the Anima Leadership in Toronto. And he said, according to neuroscientists, our next action is based on our last feeling. So instead of ignoring feelings, we can also dance with those feelings. And the feelings, they really give shape to how we navigate in the world. Instead of we thinking, oh, we just act and do in the world, we're actually feeling within the world. So for the next exercise, this is my invitation. Is if you would think of the three feelings that you have just chosen on that wheel. And if you can't remember, like me, 40 plus, like, what did I choose for that menu? Doesn't matter. Just make up those three feelings. And the invitation is that if you would allow those feelings to arise within your body, just like the wheel, maybe thinking, let's say I have chosen isolated, and happy and scared, what color would those feelings have? and where in my body would it show up? And if you're thinking, oh, Sara, I have no idea what you're talking about, that embodiment, you can also just draw them on a piece of paper. But choose however feels right for you. And you have 90 seconds for that. And for the cue, I will ring a bell. When the bell rings, we start. And when the bell rings again, we stop. And in that process, I'll also share some music and I'll put in the instruction in the chat. So 2 minutes, when the bell rings, we start. And within those 2 minutes, just notice where in your body the chosen feelings show up, what colors they might have. Everybody ready? Just give me a little bit of sign. Okay. So, and you can also move away from the screen or just turn off your camera. Do whatever your heart, your mind, and your body feels to. Here you go. I hope you have enjoyed your 90 seconds of just noting, writing, drawing, or just noticing your feelings as you have stamped them on the wheel of emotions or just how you're feeling right now. So what are feelings actually? The definition of the feeling really depends on what source you will use, but according to the different dictionary, it's actually dates back from the 16th century from Old French, and it says means something to stir up, or in Latin meaning to move out, to remove or agitate. And actually, emotions are simply internal movements of energy that causes disruption to your neutral psychological state. Or you might say, I am angry, I feel angry. There's something happening in your brain, the hormone release, and then like those movement go into your body to make you bigger so that you can attack or do something to protect. But then after those 90 seconds, all those chemicals actually disappear if you would allow those 90 seconds. But if you would repeat that loop, it's actually giving the chemicals by decision through, from your mind to your body. And also, if we look at the past 2 years of the pandemic, of the different emotions, different layers of emotions that has arise within us, and that maybe have changed. If within the Netherlands, before the pandemic, there wasn't really a word for skin hungriness, of living alone and not having contact with someone, that you feel the hungriness of your skin. And having a word for that totally describe, like, oh, that's exactly how I feel. You feel seen. So what if that we can expand how we talk about our feelings to describe the more nuanced things that we experience? Because remember what I said before, our next action is actually based on the last feeling that we have. So what if you can describe a world beyond the mad, the sad, and the glad? That you're saying, actually, my internal weather is like kind of cloudy, but with a little bit of glitter as well, because I'm actually quite excited that during this busy King's Day, I'm inside. I don't have to be in a crowded space being with drunk people. It makes you so much nuance in what, how you feel. So that is also invitation for to enter the Museum of Unnamed Feelings. And this is how we will do it. You will have 3 minutes of reading time. In the chat, there is a link. And that is the museum curated by Lily. She and I have chosen different words in different languages. We have mentioned our credit, the source as well. But you have 3 minutes of reading, and it's a link to a Google Drive. So if it shows up not too fast, it's your Zen time of today. Just allow the document to load with those images. And then let your eyes and your curiosity lead you. And like going to the Louvre, don't go for seeing all the paintings, but maybe just choose the one Mona Lisa, or actually not the Mona Lisa, but choose one painting and really connect with what you have chosen. And then you'll have 5 minutes to write or doodle about the chosen feeling. So 8 minutes in total, 3 minutes of reading and 5 minutes of doodling or writing. And you can even write a story like, hey, when was the last time I felt this? And who were there as well? What is the situation? I will time you, Donna. Thank you for the question. You can just enjoy. I'll put on the music. I'll time those 8 minutes, so about till 30, and enjoy. If you can't access the link, also shout out, let me know. And you can always ask the question by unmuting or just send me a private chat. So enjoy. Thank you. the 3 minutes of reading have passed. If you want, you can start doodling now for about 5 minutes. The last minute of doodling before we move to the next section. So welcome back, and you can stay off screen if you want to, because for the next section, we'll return to the practice of the exercise we started before, and that is those 2 minutes. Because remember those 90 seconds that you can kind of like ride the wave, and let the emotions move through you. So the invitation would be that if you can, to turn away from the screen. And I would invite, if you do have the room, because we all have different privileges, I do have a little bit of a wall behind me, so if you can, to really turn around. But if you don't have that privilege, like if I would do this session at home, I'm jammed up, so I kind of like just move away a little bit from the screen, just whatever feels comfortable for you in your situation. But the invitation is to, let me see, put that in the chat, to turn, and then I will time as well that when the bell rings, we start, and when the bell rings again, we stop. And within that first round and the second round, those 90 minutes, I invite you to feel the feeling that you have chosen from that document. So for example, within that document, I love the phrase mono no aware, of that feeling of witnessing transcendence. And for me, that's the feeling of in the autumn and seeing the trees and just that last leaf that it's turning bright orange in a way, and just before it's about to fall. And that moment, to have those 90 minutes to feel that feeling inside of you. I will start shortly, but first I'll also share the music and the screen. So here you go. To turn away and to savor the feeling that you have just chosen.
Thank you.
Welcome back. And I hope that you had the time to ride the waves and really to feel those feelings inside of you of whatever unknown feeling from that museum that you have chosen. Maybe it was something familiar, but maybe it was something that was just out of curiosity. But by giving that space, you can kind of like tune into it a bit. How would it be to feel like too much birthday? How's that excitement or not? And as we're human beings that sometimes needs alone time and sometimes needs together time, the next part is to gather in small groups in breakouts. There'll be about three of you or four of you, depending on how my tech skill is today. Sometimes it's good, sometimes not so good. But the invitation is to share within the breakout a story, or maybe just a drawing that you want to show of the feeling that you have chosen. And please feel within yourself however you would like to share that feels comfortable for you. So while I'm talking, I'm trying to, yes, I think that should be fine like this. And yeah. So yes, any questions? Okay, and if you feel shy, because sometimes I'll be a participant, I'm like, oh, this lady's so nice, I don't want to ask questions. You can also send me a private chat. Like, I have no idea what you're talking about. I have no idea what you do. So you have 12 minutes in the breakout room. Please share a story of the feeling, but choose a story that feels comfortable to you. Okay, 12 minutes and enjoy.
Is this our room, or are we supposed to go somewhere? Sorry.
No, I think this is the room I've tried. Yeah, indeed. So feel free and don't feel shy. I'm here because I'm stuck here. No, I'm here because I love to be with you. And we have 12 minutes, but it's a lot of people. So I would say whoever's next birthday is coming up can share first. What have you chosen?
I'm going to suggest, Sarah, that I send Dana to room, like one of the rooms.
Yeah, sure.
So we have like less people in there.
Yes.
Yeah.
I can
think Dana
that.
Wants to be. Oh, okay. I'll let you do that. Yeah.
And Dana, let me send you to a room with who? Oh, you guys know Heather and Carolina and Maria.
Yes. They're lovely.
Okay. Here you go. Enjoy.
Bye, Dana.
Good to see you. Where am I? Aloha.
Aloha. Aloha. Mahalo.
Where are my flowers?
Did she send herself? Where did...
I think did we you... sent you. Well, I...
Yeah.
She's still here.
Oh, let me see. Let me try.
Yeah.
Let me try as well. Yeah.
And that's just a simulation of Dana. Dana 2.0.
Oh, that's Danny. Oh, Sarah, you said sorry. Danny. It's okay. We'll go to we'll send Dana to room 5 instead. Yeah. Okay. And she's gone. Yes. Okay. Sarah, then you're okay here. Right?
Yeah.
Would you like to start sharing? Mine is September 16th. Your
mine's
birthday.
October 5th.
August 19th.
I think Sarah Jane, you won.
what about Iris and Anupa?
Anupa just joined.
Maybe she's not here.
What about Iris? Oh, great. All right. She's not. So it's me. Drawing diagram here in the laugh hole zone. And laugh hole, I believe, is when you laugh so much, you kind of enter another galactic space. I often find myself after an experience of Linerani love. And that's where you are ridiculously intimate because you'll probably never see each other again. Dread in the moment of textual dread with the person from the Linerani discussing it with the laugh holder. That's my diagram. It's not really a story, it's a diagram.
It's something. Yes. Thank you, Sarah.
Yeah. So I didn't write a story, but just like express what it was like feeling. So I went with Torch Luz Panic, and it's about like fear, like panic when there are red lights. And then there was like another one called Leniness, and it's when you want to touch little things despite whatever can happen, right? And but you feel like good on touching those. So I wrote like recently I've gone through the feeling of torchless panic, which it makes my whole self being turning inside. It seems that no matter what, another victim comes, and so I wish I could have as well experiences then that could make that go away. It seems that loneliness could help a bit, just to walk out there in the forest and find a relief to what it may start to become painful. Perhaps just by touching these little things, it could be helpful. And that's what I wrote.
I didn't write a story or a dialogue, but I channeled my inner artist and doodled. I have an energy, sorry if I butchered this, feeling crowded and desperate to find a place to be alone. I have moments, I'm an ambivert, I think. I did a test with Himeno a long time ago, and I find myself craving, I like to be with humans, but I also need time to recharge. And oh, I don't know if you can see, there you go. And I made like a visual where like there's so many people and then there's me, and there's so much going on, crowded, and it's so great when I have the energy, but when I need to like step back, I just climb. These are trees, by the way. I don't have green on my, I don't have green pens on my desk. And then I just climb back up the tree and just kind of made a tree fort for myself to just rebuild and relax and watch the happenings going around me. And I also did Krasos Mueini Neni, a joyful sorrow. And this is something I've been feeling a lot lately, where it's like it's sunshines, but it's also really, really rainy at the same time. So it's like I joyful sorrow, but I did resonate with the with this one a lot more. So yeah.
Thank you, Mim, SJ, and Jimena. And it's just, I think for me, this journey really started with, so I mean, I kind of have a story, but I don't have a story, but it started with that emotion wheel. I mean, I knew that, but there was this lady, and I can't remember her name, A von Melden, I think, and she developed this emotion wheel, but on Instagram, and then you have those sheets that you can fill in, but it's really like choose five feelings of today. And just the fact that I could choose five, you know, and that I could have contradiction feelings of, I feel excited, but also totally desperate today, because maybe during the lockdown, I went outside, the sun was shining, but at the supermarket, there was still no olive oil. I don't know, you know, so that's like, but those are just those extremes. And then the questions that she had as a reflection was also like, what's happening inside of me, in my world, but also what's happening in the world, so that I could feel those interconnectedness of, Yeah, actually, I'm feeling very restless and there's not a lot going on in my world. I mean, I'm healthy, my family's healthy, but in the world, there was a protest. There were people, you know, so that I could really, and then there was also like, where in my body is it showing? I had to draw it. And just by giving those different feelings a color and kind of like a texture, gave me so much freedom in a way. And I started to think of, and sometimes when I'm like talking with my daughter, she just turned 10. And sometimes she was just say, I don't know. And I said, do you not know because there's nothing? Or do you not know that you feel something, but you just don't have the words for it? And she said, yeah, that, I don't have the words. And we'll play a game like, okay, but if it would have a color, what color would it have? And she would be like, oh, it's green, but it's not the kind of green of a grass. It's the green of, it's like a mucky green. And I said, and if you would touch it, how would it react? It would bounce because it doesn't like to be touched. And it could just be like a game that you can play with your feelings, even though you don't have the words for it yet. So that's what I find is so fascinating about the feelings, the different layers of it, and how we can really interact. So yeah, that's me.
I think to me, a surprising moment was that I really could switch, you know, between that scribe of being thrilling emotions, right, or going on, or the Dutch leaves panic. But yet when I was thinking of the moment in which I can have this leniness of touching things and they're cute, or see, like, okay, yeah, that can bring like peace to those moments, you know, and it's not, I don't think that we can switch that easily, but it seemed that when I just went through it, like, how would it be if I were out there, right? And then you like, maybe there are so many like mushrooms outside that I would like to, but you don't know, right, if they're good or bad to touch, because that's what you're told. Or if you see an insect and it looks like so nice, but you're scared of it, whether you don't, but if you could touch it, it's just like, and that emotion still, would that change to another one? Yeah.
It definitely shows that, like, Ximena, you're a very curious person. Yeah, like, you're filled with curiosity.
Yeah, like, she's like, what's this?
Mushrooms, insects, bugs, yay.
Yeah, but unfortunately, but I have to be careful. So, maybe you want to.
Sarah Jane, welcome back.
Sorry, somebody in the house was having some feelings. I really appreciate this PDF, Sarah, and I'm wondering, I work with a group of psychologists and psychiatrists, and we're working on workshop for clinically depressed adolescents. So we're running, and I use a really banal scale called PANAS, P-A-N-A-S. And I would love to show them your document if you, I don't
yes,
know.
Yes, please do. Yeah, sure. So there are, and also, I mean, Lily, she made all the beautiful art. And at the last page, we also incorporated the sources that we have used. So really feel free to use it.
And, I mean, this is the PDF that when we clicked on this particular Google Doc, where it's
yes.
like,
okay. Yeah, indeed. And the last, so these, No, you go first.
These words actually exist.
Yes, indeed. Okay. So there is the one of the first document is like a research by a professor, and he really interviewed different people. And apparently, like, there is a feeling, I think it was in Swedish, that the feeling of sitting on your couch on a Sunday with only your underwear and with a cold beer in their hand. There's a word for that. And we just selected all those feelings. But feel free to use them because we really want to, we're also inspired by it. So,
okay, great.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So welcome back. Let's just wait for the others to arrive as well. And while we wait, it's always nice to have some music while we wait. So if you have just returned from your breakout room, either with some awkward silence or some good silence or some unfinished stories, take the time to settle, just like on an airplane, and that you just landed with the jet lag and feel the music in your ears and the vibrations of the music, like the feelings that arise. And whenever you have those difficult feelings or too big of a feeling, you're thinking not right now, just remember those 90 seconds that you can ride it out. Let the chemicals rush through your body. Remember where the phrase feelings come from 16th century, of to move, this internal physical sensation within you. Looking at the time, I've promised Mim and Ximena to finish on time. And so the last bit I would like to ask you is just like in going to a museum, remember that you went through the Louvre, and then just before you go out, there's also this little museum shop, and maybe you don't have a lot of money, you're like, yeah, let me just buy a postcard, or maybe you have kids with you, it's like, mommy, can I buy this? But just like imagine you're now in this museum shop, and my question for you is just to check within yourself, what is the souvenir that you're leaving with after this experience, after being in the museum of unnamed feelings? And whenever you're ready, share that in the chat with us. What is the souvenir that you're leaving with? And it could also be something you just can't put in words. You can also use the emojis. Sometimes a lot of things can be better expressing emojis. Of the little chicklet on just out of the egg, and the refrigerator magnet is always good. New language. Thank you so much, and keep them coming in. And if you don't want to share, because sometimes it's like the facilitator can ask for something, but I'm not ready to share yet. You don't have to. You can also just write it in your own notebook. It's just your feelings. You don't have to share them if you're not ready to. But I hope you have taken something away from this session when it comes to feelings, that you have given yourself the space to feel all those feels. And with that said, I'm going to hand it back to, I think, Ximena. And thank you so much for your attention today.
Thank you so much.
Can we give a round of applause for Sara? Yay.
Bravo, bravo.
Thank you, Sara.
Thank you so much. Lovely. And tomorrow we're just about to present the session and introducing to you what we will have next coming.
Yes. So next session, we have a online board game. So Cozy Juicy Reel. It's called Cozy Juicy Reel. And we have the founders, Jed and Sophia Lazar, who will be with us next week. And you will get to also dig deep into your emotions, as well as also connect with other WebGen community members with this game. So please join us. I've played the game myself, but in another session. So please join. I can promise you it's really fun. And please follow our social medias. And, you know, we're known as Wednesday Web Jam. And these are all of our crew members we are all volunteers. So some of us are here, some of us are not here. Thank you for the support. And thank you also everybody for the support on Ko-fi, for keeping the jam going. And next slide, Ximena. And yes, feel free to hang out with us on the backstage. But before we go, if you stop sharing, Ximena, yes. Stop sharing and we wave goodbye to the recording. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Goodbye recording.
And we see you next week.
YouTube.
Goodbye YouTube.